A Michigan legislator is apologizing for using racial slurs against her Asian American opponent for state Senate. According to the Detroit Metro Times, State Representative Betty Cook Scott, seen on the left, used slurs. And I apologize for even repeating them. Ching Chang and Ching Chong when referring to her opponent, State Representative Stephanie Chang, during a recent Democratic primary. Witnesses told the paper that during the August 7th election, Scott also referred to a campaign volunteer as an immigrant and said, "These immigrants from China are coming over and taking our community from us." Scott released a statement via her attorney, reading in part, "I deeply regret the comments I made that have proven hurtful to so many. Those are words I never should have said. I humbly apologize to Representative Chang, her husband, Mr. Gray, and to the broader Asian American community for those disparaging remarks." In this divisive age we find ourselves in, this is still in the statement, "I should not contribute further to that divisiveness." All right. So now what? Joining me, Michigan State Representative Stephanie Chang. Good to see you, Representative. So what are your thoughts now that there is also an apology coming from Betty Cook Scott?
Well, first, thanks so much for having me. Obviously, myself and many others were really disappointed to hear the remarks from Representative Scott on Election Day last Tuesday. But now that there has been the beginning of an apology through her attorney, she and I, along with some other members of the Asian American community that I've invited, we will be meeting this coming Thursday to talk. And, you know, I'm really looking forward to that conversation. I hope that it's a productive one. I think that many people were hurt by what she said. And so I'm hopeful that we can have a conversation where she really learns about the impact of her words and why the Asian American community, the immigrant community, why residents in her own district are so deeply offended, and why we really need to do better. She's an elected official. As a public servant, we really need to respect every single person in our communities. And so I'm hopeful that this conversation can be one where we all learn something and where hopefully we can come away with a better understanding of the respect that we need to show every person.
And we invited State Representative Betty Cook Scott to appear with us, and we did not get, you know, a thumbs up on joining us today, but that you all will be meeting and that there will be discussions. I mean, that potentially, I guess, will give you some, I guess, some real hope or some a real objective in your conversation. I mean, how do you approach this conversation? What's on your wish list of accomplishments from that conversation?
Sure. Well, so I want to point out a couple things. First, the call for an apology actually started with an Asian American civic engagement group, Asian Pacific Islander American Vote Michigan, which then actually got, by this point, actually over 30 organizations to sign on. And so I'm trying to really remind folks that this whole situation is really not about me. It really is about the words that Representative Scott used and the impact on the broader community. Because she used those words throughout the day, and many people heard them, and they've had a ripple effect. So,
right, it wasn't just once, but apparently it was, you know, often over many hours, in fact.
Yes, yes. And so I think what's really important in a conversation like this on Thursday is to use it as an opportunity to make sure that the Asian American community and other allies who have really stood by our side on this to actually really educate Representative Scott about what contributions the Asian American community and immigrants have made to this country, to really hit home the point that we need to do better, that public officials and elected representatives need to hold themselves to a high standard of professional conduct, and also to respect every single person in our state that she serves. So I'm hopeful that the conversation can be one where she really listens to what exactly the impact of her words were. And I hope that we can come away from that meeting, with a sign of progress. I'm grateful that there was the start of an apology through her attorney on social media. But I think the most important thing is to actually make sure that we're growing from this situation.
All right. Representative Stephanie Chang, thanks so much for your time. Appreciate it. And all the best on the upcoming meetings.
Thanks so much.